Bone marrow transplantation is actually a stem cell therapy. It works because you're transferring these stem cells in the bone marrow that can regenerate the blood. As we know, bone marrow transplant can be used now to treat many diseases, particularly several forms of cancer. And there are new exciting therapies using bone marrow transplant to treat autoimmune and other diseases. Other kinds of stem cell therapies that are going on today, again with adult stem cells, we can use skin stem cells to treat skin grafts for burn patients, corneal grafts for eye damage. So these are ongoing therapies that are in the clinic today. Regenerative medicine is going to mean that we will not just be treating chronic diseases. We have the capacity in certain cases to really effect cures. And that is an incredibly exciting opportunity. So worldwide, we're beginning to see the first clinical trials for products derived from pluripotent stem cells, and we certainly expect to see some of those coming forward to the clinic here in Ontario and around the world in the next few years. However, one has to be very careful. There have to be careful analysis of the safety of these products. We have to show that they work and actually treat disease, and we have to be able to scale up the cells that we can produce in a petri dish to levels of numbers that we can use to treat patients. And the Ontario Institute for Regenerative Medicine, along with the Centre for Commercialisation for Regenerative Medicine, are really working to ensure that we can speed up and enhance the pipeline from discovery to the clinic. We're doing that through the development of disease teams, which bring together scientists, bioengineers and clinicians with industry partners and partners in CCRM with their platform technologies to really enhance the progress from discovery to the clinic. So many patients are potentially seeking treatments outside of Canada, outside of the regulated clinical trials that we can undertake here. And they're going to clinics around the world who are offering therapies that in many cases are unproven. It's very important when patients are looking at therapies outside of Canada that they ask serious questions of those clinics. Have they published their results? Do they have really a clear regulatory environment in which those therapies are taking place? What are the references that they can take, that they can offer? And indeed, very carefully assessing whether the therapies that are being proposed have a scientific basis in fact.